Hi, welcome to Anastasia Chornaya Show. My name is Anastasia Chornaya, and today we're going to be talking about leasing versus financing a car. We will weigh in the pros and cons, and we will also take a look at what exactly is it that you need to make sure you have a successful transaction with any dealership when it comes to leasing and financing. Let's take a look at the definition of leasing and financing. Basically, leasing means that you are agreeing with the terms that you will be borrowing a car from a dealership for a set period of time. So basically, the dealership purchases the car, the brand new car for you, and then they are going into terms with you to have that said car be used by you for a set amount of time, for a set amount of miles. When you're financing a car, what happens is that you are applying for credit from any financial institution or from a dealership itself to own the car, but make payments for a certain period of time. So what happens is that with leasing, you're borrowing the car, which means you have to bring it back at some point. But with financing, you are ultimately working on a goal of owning the car once you pay it off. So let's take a look at what actually makes up the price of the monthly payments that you will be making if you're leasing a car. There's quite a few factors. The first one would be MSRP, which is manufacturer's suggested retail price. The good news about that is that you do not necessarily have to pay that much money for that car, because it's a beautiful country where you can negotiate the price down. And once you do your negotiations, that final price would be capitalized value or capitalized cost of that car, which will be one of the main determining factors in how much you will be paying monthly for said car. Other factors would be residual value, which will be the price of that car once you return it at the end of the term. Also, there is a depreciation, which is the difference between the capital value and the residual value of the car. And there's also money factor, which is basically the percentage that the dealership will be charging you on top of the price that you are supposed to be paying for that car, because they're the ones who actually purchase the car to then rent it out to you. The last factor that you have to consider that will go into your monthly payments is the upfront fees that you may be paying for the car, which will include the down payment, the processing and acquisition fees. It will also be the security deposit that you will have to pay for the car, taxes for that car. All of that will be included into the monthly payment. So what is it exactly that makes people decide for or against leasing a car? So let's take a look at some pros and cons. One of the great things about leasing a car is the fact that you get to drive a brand new car pretty much forever, because every 2 to 4 years you can exchange that car for a newer model, which comes with this great thing of lower costs of maintenance, because generally you don't really need to do much with the car. Even if something goes wrong, it's usually covered under manufacturer's warranty for the first couple of years of the existence of said car. Also, leasing a car comes with lower monthly payments. You can basically afford driving a more expensive car because you're not paying to own it. You're just borrowing it. Now, here's why it would suck to lease a car. You have to make sure that your income is predictable, because you will have to make consistent payments every single month. And if you don't, you will be charged fees. If you decide to, let's say, end your lease before the actual end of the contract, you will have to pay the fee to do so, which is, it can be tricky, because a lot of times dealerships would charge you so much in fees that might actually end up being about the same as if you were driving the car up until the end of the lease. You will have to pay a fee if you decide not to purchase the vehicle at the end of the term. Also, wear and tear. Basically, leasing a car means that you have to bring that vehicle back in the same condition as it was when you drove off the lot when you signed that leasing contract, which is practically impossible in this world. One of the biggest drawbacks of leasing a car personally for me, and I've mentioned it in my previous video, is the mileage cap. So because the dealership wants to make sure that residual value of the car is as high as possible, they only give you a certain amount of miles that you can drive per year. Usually it's anywhere between 10 and 15,000 miles. If you drive more than the amount of miles that you agreed upon, you will have to pay per mile. You do not get any reward if you do not use up your miles in that said year. And for people like me who drive a lot of miles, and I know exactly how many miles I drive, and that's way more than 15,000 a year just for my job, and I'm not even considering the road trips that I take, I know exactly that this would be the reason why leasing would not be an option for me personally. So right now you might be wondering, what is it to finance a car? Well, let me tell you. So basically, it means that you are borrowing money from financial institution to help you with purchasing the car. And at the end, you will end up owning the car once you pay off all of that money. What's going to be included into your monthly payments if you're financing the vehicle? Basically, it is the same as the leasing. The same MSRP goes into play, but then if you negotiate the payment of that car, then capitalized cost is basically what's going to be the main determining factor of approximately how much you're going to be paying. Of course, there's some fees, there's some taxes. Also, what will be taken into consideration is the APR, basically the percentage rate that you will be paying to the financial institution. When you are shopping for a vehicle, you also need to make sure that you're shopping for different financing options, different financing institutions, so that you can determine what works better for you. And make sure to read the fine print to learn about how it's going to work. All of that depends on your credit score and your down payment. Those things will determine how much you can pay. You can also use a trade-in, which if you own a vehicle right now that you're not intending on driving anymore, you can turn it in to the dealership as your down payment. And the trade-in value will be determined by the dealership, which is super low, versus you selling that car by yourself and then using the money that you make from selling the car to put as down payment. Just personal experience. So here are the cons of financing a vehicle. You will be having to pay more money on monthly basis. So basically your monthly payments will be a little bit higher, or in some terms, a lot higher than leasing monthly payments. Driving a vehicle for many years, you do end up having to do some maintenance on it, which you have to pay for. That's really it. Honestly, like, I don't see any drawbacks in financing a vehicle, because I'm the type of a person who actually buys a car to drive literally until the wheels fall off. Also, when you're purchasing a vehicle and you're financing it, you can ask them about older models. Like, for instance, when I was looking at the cars, it was between Camry and Corolla for me, and they offered me to buy a 2020 Camry. They were trying to sell those off, so they had really great discounts for those cars and also 0% APR. Every month, they have a new special going on. Japanese cars definitely have a reputation of being way more reliable. You have to also look into how much does it cost to have different types of repairs on that car. Let's talk about what you will need to either lease or finance a vehicle. Pretty much both of them work and depend largely on your credit score. You will need your social security number, you will need your personal information like your name, your address, your work history or what you do right now, your monthly gross earnings, your annual earnings, other payments that you might be making monthly, like your rent, your telephone, your utilities, your internet, or if you're, let's say, leasing or financing another vehicle in the family. In either cases, you will have to fill out a credit application, which will actually include all of that information for them to request your credit score through one of the governmental companies like Equifax or TransUnion. The thing with credit score, if you're new or semi-new to the country and your credit history is not that, you know, extended and financial institutions are not too eager to give you any kind of credit, you might want to consider getting somebody to co-sign with you. But there's a few things that you have to remember about that. You have to really know the person and trust them, as well as they have to make sure that they trust you with that stuff, because it is a great financial responsibility. And if you and that person, the co-signer, becomes responsible for making the payments and maintaining the contract between you and the dealership in either of the cases, which means that if, let's say, you are not able to make a monthly payment, the responsibility falls onto the co-signer of this, and it will be reflected on both your credit history and theirs. So to summarize this whole video, please make sure that you do your own research on whether leasing or financing is actually right for you. Also research the kind of car you want to purchase before you sit down to process any kind of paperwork for either of the contracts that you decide that are better for you. Another thing that you might want to look into is your credit score, which you can get for free on your bank statements, or you can request it through like Credit Karma or other services that offer you your credit score. Well, this is pretty much it. This is all the information that I wanted to share with you guys today, and I hope you really enjoyed it. I hope it was informative for you. If there's anything else that you would like to see in the future videos, if you have any questions, just let me know right there. Give me some love. Let's create this community together and support each other. Either way, please like this video, subscribe to my channel. There's more information to come. There's more goodness to come. And I am looking forward to seeing you in the next video. Have a great day. Bye.